Yo, what is up? I'm Chris and we're Endless Sauce here, and today we'll be bringing you part 7 of the What If on What If All For One and All Might Swap Places. Now, this will be the last What If, or the last part for the What If, until season 5 is done, because we don't want to go, into manga stuff. We just want to stick to anime. So, right now, this will be the last part until season 5 is completed. It's like how we have What If Deku knew full counting before the entrance exam. We're stopping this until season 5 is completed or when it's near completed, because we don't want to go too into the manga. I just want to say that I do have an idea on what's gonna be the next what if. I wanted to make it interesting, something completely different from the story, so I hope y'all are excited for that next My Hero Academia what if. But other than that, if you have any ideas for any other what ifs, leave it down in the comments down below, and we'll make sure to reply to your comment. And we'll s let's get into part 7 on What If All For One and All Might Swap Places. At a villain lair, Shigaraki had a discussion with the rest of the League of Villains about a man who can be used to them in making their league stronger. The man they're talking about is the head of the Shihaseki Overhaul, and Shigaraki sends twice to get Overhaul to come meet them in a secret hideout and tells them to make sure he's not followed by anyone. Twice heads out and brings Overhaul to the secret hideout. Twice an Overhaul arrives, and Shigaraki states his plan to Overhaul on killing Midoriya, and asks Overhaul if he is willing to join the League of Villains. Overhaul will criticize the way Shigaraki runs things and states on how he lost big villains like Muscular and Moonfish in an amateur assault on UA. Shigaraki gets pissed off hearing this and sends Mr. Compress to seal Overhaul, but Overhaul destroys Mr. Compress's arm and kills Mayne. Overhaul soldiers then arrived at the hideout, and before they escaped, Overhaul tells Shigaraki that when he finally gets a chance to cool off, they can discuss things a little bit better. Shigaraki is pissed, but then ultimately decides to have another meeting with Overhaul later on and focuses on getting Mr. Compressed healed. Now that Midoriya is working at Nainite's agency, Nainite assigns both Mirio and Midoriya to patrol around the city to see if there are any problems, and so that Mirio can show Midoriya the ropes into becoming a hero. Before Midoriya and Mirio head out, Nainai warns them about a villain that they've been trying to look for named Overhaul. While Midoriya and Mirio go out on patrol, they meet Eri as usual, and also have the meetup with Overhaul. Midoriya would want to fight Overhaul, but Mirio stops him as normal, and they would go tell Sir Nainai. A meeting would be held with many superheroes. Everyone is talking while then Rock Lock does go to the fact saying, "Why are kids here?" And this remark does anger Midoriya a bit. He then stands up saying, "How dare he call him a kid?" He stares at Rock Lock, stating that he is the only hero besides All For One that could fight the most dangerous villain alone. Midoriya shouts that he may not be a pro hero, but he at least deserves a little respect as he marches away angrily. This does catch the eye of Mirio, Uraraka, Sue, and Kirishima. They all understand why he's all angry and acting tough, and they all do feel bad for him. This does also shock the pro heroes on how Midoriya acted. Back to Midoriya, he sits down and thinks to himself on what just overcame him. Uraraka goes out to him and talks to him, asking if he's all right, and Midoriya looks down saying no. He says that the death of All For One is still on his mind, and he still blames himself for not being strong enough to protect him. There's also so much weight he has to carry with being the successor. Uraraka believes this, but she says that she knows Midoriya is hiding something else. Midoriya breaks, telling Uraraka the secret of his quirks, and this shocks Uraraka, but she promises that she won't tell anyone. Their plans of attacking Overhaul would play out the same up until Midoriya has to deal with Eri and Overhaul. I would say Midoriya will still have Eri on his back still, but with the way she reverses him will be different. Since she is constantly reversing him, Midoriya's stock of pain will go back to max over and over again, so he uses that to the advantage to keep using 100% of his power against Overhaul, and he defeats him much more easily than he did in the actual show. Overhaul is defeated. He's arrested and is being taken away, but Shigaraki stops the vehicle he is being taken away in and decays Overhaul's arms, then walks away. Back to the heroes. The one that had the major part in the mission were injured and were taken to the hospital. But most of it goes the same, with Mirio losing his quirk, and Midoriya blames himself for not arriving sooner to help him, and starts to tear up, but Mirio asks him why he's crying and not to worry about it, because Mirio's fine with him losing his quirk, as long as Eri's okay. Midoriya wipes his tears, then a nurse walks in and tells him that Sir Naida wants to talk to them. And they go to see him as he says his final words to the both of them and passes away. Both Mirio and Midoriya break down in tears. Both Midoriya quickly wipes them off his tears, telling himself that he needs to be stronger. He now also blames the death of Sir Naida with him, and he has more guilt with both pro heroes on him dying. Everything from here would go the same, from the festival to gentle criminal attacking and being stopped by Midoriya. And Eri would smile from seeing the class 1A performance. Alright guys, that's where we're going to end off part 7 of What If All For One All My Swap Places. I do already have a what if in plan for the next My Hero Academia what if. Leave it down in the comments down below what do you think about this what if and how it would affect, you know, season 5. We promise that we will make another part of this what if and the previous what if from My Hero we had when season 5 is close to done, or when this arc that is currently happening is finished. If you have any ideas for any My Hero what ifs or any other what ifs, leave them down in the comments down below and we will make sure we reply to your comments. Other than that, guys, thank y'all so much for watching. Thank y'all for all the support on our channel. And we'll see y'all next video. Thanks for watching.